I always enjoy Comic-Cons. I guess I'm a relatively newcomer to the Comic-Con world. So I've only been doing it for maybe 2 or 3 years now. And I think there's a lot of misconceptions about what happens at cons, I think, for actors. And I didn't know what to expect until I started doing them. But it's just like, you know, it's love fest. It's like, it's great. It's people celebrating, all that is awesome. And I think as an actor, you spend most of your life where people don't really give two shits about what you're doing. So it's always nice to come and talk to people who actually care and who've actually watched your stuff and, you know, have some sort of passion for things you've done rather than, you know, people who don't care. So, yeah, I've had a blast. And Manchester's a cool city. I've gotten to see a little bit. I've only had a couple meals, a little fish and chips, you know, a little full English in the morning. It's cool. I actually really like the this venue is like kind of cool. It's like a Harry Potter. I don't know. You know, it just looks really cool. That was Coral's quote right there. But yeah, it's a cool building. And it seems like there's a train station. Well, it's a good thing I came here on time and got my train. I get a lot of different questions. I guess because I play a lot of different kind of characters, I get a lot of questions about, everyone's always kind of like disappointed that I don't talk like my characters or something. Like, I feel like that's mostly I'm just like disappointing, you know, to them. Like, you know, they're like, but you're so cool on TV and you're so lame in person. Like, you know, it's kind of the classic one. I feel like I get, I also just get a lot of questions, I think, from like younger actors. I feel like a lot of you get a lot of questions of like, how do you do this? And you know, my answer is usually pretty much the same. Like, just like, you just do it. Like, I mean, it's like Nike. You know, just do it, and you don't take no for an answer, and you keep going. But I get a lot of questions about vocal stuff. I get a lot of questions about my hair. Like, people, it's really weird. Like, people, because like, I guess people, you know, you shoot something like months before people see it, and then like, you know, like, I think like by the time like Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. was airing, like, my hair was already like longer again because my hair grows really fast. So people are like, well, did you cut it or wearing a wig? Like, you just get such random like funny questions, like things that you didn't think of that, you know, that would be interesting. But you know, I get a lot of different questions. I try to answer them the best I can without rambling, but obviously I ramble.
What's been the highlight of your career?
That I have one. You know, that's probably the highlight of my career. There's so many highlights, to be honest. I really love acting, so essentially every time I get to act, I really enjoy it, and that's kind of a highlight. But, you know, I think Black Sails was a really special show. It was its like own kind of little world, and that was really special. But there's lots of special moments like that. I mean, I really love, I've loved every show I've worked on. So, I mean, there's just, actors are really cool, and I get to hang out and work with a lot of them. I think maybe one of the biggest highlights in my career is probably just getting to work with people who I'm a fan of. Like, you know, when you're a fan of someone and then you actually get to work with them, that's pretty cool. And that's happened so many times. I mean, it's hard to really say, but I kind of, I recently did a movie with Danny Glover that was just really just so cool because he's just, you know, he's like still not too old for this shit somehow. He's just amazing. So, yeah.
If you have to choose someone to work with, an actor that's dead, who would you love to work with?
Ooh, that's dead. I mean, I've gotten to work with a lot of greats, but there's so many people I'd work with who are no longer with us. You know, I was like a huge Robin Williams fan, like just such a big fan of his my whole life, and just so impressed with kind of the scope of what he was able to convince people of on camera and off camera. Just, you know, I mean, just like things like Miss Doubtfire, you're like, wow, I mean, he actually pulled that off. That's like, it's really hard stuff to pull off. I mean, he as an adult man, played a little boy in Jack, you know, like, that's just amazing, you know. So I think he'd probably be one of kind of like the top of my list. And, you know, it was really sad to see him go recently, but he'd probably be up there at the top. And also I just feel like I'd want to sit in the cast tent with him and listen to him talk for hours. Just, okay, Robin.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But yeah, there's more, but you know, him is one of them. Oh, what's next? You know, it's so funny because there's always this, I guess, this perception that like actors just get to like choose what's next for them. But it's just so not the way that really works. So what's next? I mean, like what's next that you will see has probably already been shot. And what's next for me is stuff that I probably won't be able to talk about until somebody at a PR company tells me I'm allowed to talk about it. I've got a couple irons in the fire on some new things and a couple things I'm doing. But the next thing I think I'm actually shooting, I can tell you about because the pilot I did called LA's Finest got picked up and it's shooting in LA in a couple of months. I think it starts shooting in the end of August, which is just around the corner already. That's like it's like a Bad Boys spinoff TV show where they've kind of revisioned it with female leads, and I don't know if you've seen it, but Gabrielle Union and Jessica Alba are playing kind of the main title kind of roles in it. The pilot came out really great, and I'm excited to go have fun with them. It shoots in Los Angeles, so it doesn't even really feel like work when you work in Los Angeles as an actor, because acting work is very difficult and has its own challenges and whatnot, but if you love it and it's fun, you know, I love acting, so like it's more like the traveling that's the work and the like, you know, staying in shape for things that's the work. The actual playing is fun. So it shoots in LA, so it's like literally, I mean, it just feels like I'm playing, you know. And I'm like, oh, I'll just go down there and play. It's great. So yeah, that's probably the next thing I'm shooting. Although there's an odd chance I might be going to Rome very soon too. Also, I don't, you know, there's so like, there's, as an actor, there's like literally like things that like, you know, they always say you don't know what's actually happening until you're there doing it. And then you don't even know it's going to happen until they announce it, because they can always change things up on you and whatnot, or just cut you out or change your recast or all kinds of things. So, you know, what's next for me? More acting. You know, yeah, I mean, it's funny because playing heroes and playing villains, you know, there's like a difference to it. But I think all actors in some ways, you know, it's the inner child in you that kind of drives the desire to do this. You know, I mean, I'm a grown man with like children and I play make-believe for a living, so you know there's some sort of child clearly still inside of me. But yeah, the genre stuff, I think you just, there's just things you can't do in projects that aren't genres, whether it's hero stuff, whether it's superpowers or all that. I've actually never really had any superpowers yet. I'm just doing like me usually. I'm looking forward to one day where they just like give me the ability to just do some with my hand. I don't have to punch him in the face or something. I mean, get punched in the face. But yeah, I think that's you know, that's something I look forward to, and I think everyone likes. I mean, the genre's just cool. I mean, when it's pulled off and you really enter, you know, these kind of worlds, it's amazing what you can do, and then how grounded you can make it. So yeah, somewhere in there might be an answer. I don't know. No question about it, but Wolverine is the best person who ever had powers, in my opinion. You know, I've never been a Superman fan, really, as much, or like, you know, like, I think you can give someone too many powers, and then they're no longer interesting, and that's a problem I have with Superman. Like, he's just not vulnerable enough to me. Like, I always loved Batman, because he was, like, he was rich and he had some cool toys, but when it came down to it, it was just a person in there, in the suit. Wolverine I always loved the most because, you know, he doesn't really have a superpower. He's just really tough. Like, you know, that's his superpower, is that he's, you know, he regenerates, yeah, but in reality, he's just really tough. Like, he's just, like, the toughest regenerate. You know, he's the person who can constantly get back up when he's knocked down, and that's what I guess, that's what a hero is to me, is really, like, someone who doesn't get knocked down, like, it's like, well, all right, there's no stakes. You're just going to steamroll over everyone, and there's no danger to it. So that's Wolverine has just always been my favorite, and I don't know why. Also, because maybe there's like a slim chance I might get to play him one day or something. So
that's part of your ultimate career ambition, then.
For sure, yeah. If I could play Wolverine, I say this now. I think I'd be like, I'm done acting, you know, whatever. But I probably wouldn't. I'd just be really happy that I got to do it, and then be doing everything else I could do too. So that's just who I am.
You could trade any DC character to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Who would it be?
Any DC character? Well, I mean, I really like Batman. You know, so I feel like Batman would be great in there. You know, I've always liked Batman. He's awesome. Although, you know, it's funny, my favorite superhero thing too, I guess I could kind of amend it, because even though I'm not that big of a Superman fan, it turns out I'm actually a huge Wonder Woman fan, which I don't know why that is, but because I don't think they didn't present her as being as invulnerable as Batman, as Superman is. Like, she was vulnerable. Like, she, you know, you met her as a little girl, and she was training and all those things. But mostly, I think that one was the best for me, just because I have daughters, and just kind of watching them watch that was really emotional. So, you know, these events, you do run into that a lot. Really emotional kind of responses from people, and people who are very touched by your work or inspired by what you do, and that. I mean, that always actually, you know, makes these things quite worth it, because it's really easy to forget the effect that, like, as an actor, that you, like, you know, that people see you in, you know, in the box, in the TV, and they see you on social media, and that you may be inspiring them for things that, and you're not even necessarily trying to do that. Like, that's just happening. But, you know, I'm just trying to, like, take care of my kids and family, and, you know, save for their college, and, you know, paint the house, and, you know, all the normal things that humans deal with. And so you kind of, I mean, my mind goes to that, but there's been a lot of experiences at cons. I haven't had a huge one like that just yet here, but I'm sure it'll come soon enough. But yeah, I mean, when you feel that, you know, get brought to you, you know, someone is really, you know, changed, you know, so that you've affected positive change in someone is a really powerful thing, and it means a lot. You know, I've heard actors be like, you know, oh, I don't care, but I every time I hear that, I'm like, wow, that's awesome. You really, like, me, little old me, you know, that's the way I feel about it. So yeah, I've had quite a few of those experiences. There's also it's also cool, like, when you see someone who cosplays a character you've played, because that's just, like, I don't know, it's like the ultimate form of flattery, I guess, for an actor in some ways. In fact, on Black Sails, I think there was a Charles cosplayer before any other character that was, like, doing everything, and, like, everyone was really, like, jealous that, you know, like Toby was like, where's my f-? and then they kind of came, but it's really a special thing to kind of see that, and, you know, to have any effect on people, or to inspire people is just cool. So I'm happy to do it, and happy to be here.